Steve Bannon is one of the people who was closest to the president ideologically, if not personally. The president has said that he came into the campaign late, but that he was clearly a force during the campaign and a force there at the White House. But we are now told by two sources that Steve Bannon will be leaving the White House. I was communicating with him this morning on some other issues. He deferred when I asked him whether or not he was coming or going, but it looks like the president has decided, after a review that was conducted by his chief of staff, John Kelly, to remove Steve Bannon from his position as his chief strategist. It's also likely, too, that this is just the first shoe to drop. I mean, there is, you know, it's no secret, although the White House has really kind of tried to paper over it, but it's no secret that there have been a number of rivalries in the White House. There was Steve Bannon, sometimes against Reince Priebus, sometimes allied with Reince Priebus against some of the other factions in the White House, including Jared Kushner and Gary Cohen. So I don't know for sure, Sandra, but I would think that this is not the last departure that we're going to hear of from this White House. Now, a lot of people, by the way, have said that Steve Bannon is the president's connection to the base. In some ways, he is, but he's also got Kellyanne Conway, who very much is in touch with the president's base, as well as women in the Republican Party. And so the fact that Steve Bannon is leaving will be a loss for the president, but he does have some other backup there in terms of maintaining that connection to the base and certainly to Republican women, Sandra.
I just wanted to get this in here, reporting from Catherine Herridge, saying in her intelligence contact says he learned about 40 minutes ago about this news from a senior Republican Party source, saying concerns for Republican Party, believes continued fallout with General Kelly played a role in all of this. John?
Yeah, and you know, General Kelly doesn't have the easiest job around either. You know, he comes from a military background. He is well-versed in politics in terms of him being the political liaison chief of staff for the Secretaries of Defense, Leon Panetta, as well as Robert Gates. But don't forget, you're dealing with Donald Trump here, and there's only so much you can do to try to keep the president's ship on course, to keep that train rolling down the tracks before you quickly become persona non grata in the president's eyes. And some people that I've been talking to say that what the president did earlier this week in that bizarre press conference in Trump Tower was in a way to say to General Kelly, well, you may be trying to control me, but I'm the one who's going to control me. Let's not forget you're the chief of staff. You work for me. I am the boss. So General Kelly, I think, he's probably got a very tough challenge there. If he thought that going into Iraq in 2003
wow,
was a
yeah.
challenge when he was the first Marines, he's got a real challenge on his hands.
Yeah.
And he goes from Department of Homeland Security, which is a thankless job, and one that keeps you up all night, now to being the chief of staff for this
well,
president.
We
so
thank him for his work service.